Hey guys, I wanted to make a quick video just talking about some of the new cards that are going to be coming out in this new box set for Noble Knights. There's only three cards, three new ones. Obviously, all the other ones are getting re-released, but I really think they're very interesting, and I do really like what they're trying to do with Noble Knights. I'm honestly not as familiar with the archetype. I have built it before, but it's not one that I've worked on very much. I do think it's a very fun archetype, and it has a lot of things going for it. And I'm just going to talk about how the cards could really kind of supplement what the archetype is trying to do. So one of the new cards, Merlin. This card is really interesting for Noble Knights, allowing them to special summon whatever Noble Knight they want. That is extremely powerful. A lot of decks do have a searching card, but this one that searches out everything from a special summon is very powerful, especially with how the Noble Knights work. You can use this to special summon something to get you started, to get certain effects activating. Just really nice. And its graveyard effect is also very nice, that you can trigger XYZ or Synchros whenever you want. Obviously not a super powerful effect, but it's really nice to kind of deal with certain things that are happening on the field. It really lets you kind of counter certain things that make target cards, and it just lets you get the Noble Arms cards, trigger them, just activate things when you really need them to be activated. So I really think Merlin's going to be a very nice card for this deck type. And then they're getting another Noble Knight, Noble Knight Bedwyr. This one's really interesting because it's not like the other Noble Knights. It's not, gain a level and become dark and then gain its effect. It's not like that. It's just a card that really helps your consistency. It just allows you to equip those arms cards from the graveyard, which is very powerful because obviously you send a lot of those cards to the graveyard early on, and then you want to, XYZ to get them back or something like that. But now you have a card like Bedwyr, so even if you don't XYZ, you can start to bring the Noble Arms cards back onto the field very nicely and start blowing over your opponent. Now you won't even need those XYZs in order to make plays. So I really think this will be a very nice card for the archetype. And then Last Chapter of Noble Knights, another really great card. This one is kind of like Bedwyr, but also gives you a special summon power, allowing you to get whatever you need and then get a Noble Arms equip card. It just lets you start things so quickly between some of the Noble Arm cards you want to, activate and the effects you want to activate. This card will let you make plays very quickly for you. I really do like it. Very nice support card for Noble Knights. So again, those are the only three cards that are coming in this pack, but you can see that I think these three are very good for what the deck is trying to do. A lot of consistency stuff, a lot of kind of comeback ability, allowing them to get some consistency from the Noble Arms cards and really getting what they need. They can thin their deck a little more now and kind of use the graveyard more effectively, which I feel like will be very powerful for them to set up their XYZs, to set up just having strong presence on the field without their XYZs. So I think there will be a lot going on there, and I do really like this, and I'm looking forward to using some of these cards when I do rebuild my Noble Knight deck. But if any of you guys are excited about these cards, let me know down in the comments. Maybe people who are more familiar with the archetype can tell me why these cards are terrible, but I do think they'll be really effective in trying to do what this deck is aimed for. But yeah, let me know in the comments below. That's about it for me. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you later.